Day 6. Holy Week Reflection on Good Friday. Dear friends, Good Friday is the day of the crucifixion, the day Jesus died for the sins of the world. All through the previous night, Jesus had been locked in the dungeon of the high priest's house. Early in the morning, he was brought before Pontius Pilate, who transferred the case to Herod. Herod promptly sent Jesus back to Pilate. Sometime in the middle of the morning, Pilate bowed to the pressure of the temple leadership and the crowds and condemned Jesus to a horrible death by crucifixion. Late in the morning, Jesus was taken by soldiers through the city and up the hillside of Golgotha. By noon, he had been nailed to the cross, where he hung in agony for about 3 hours. Jesus died at approximately 3 o'clock in the afternoon. He was taken down from the cross and hastily placed in a tomb before sundown. Good Friday is a mandatory day of fasting and abstinence. Many parishes gather together for the Stations of the Cross and for recollections of the 7 last words of Jesus. Some offer the Stations of the Cross at 3 p.m., the hour of Jesus' death. The parish altar looks very different on Good Friday. It is plain and bare. There is no consecrated host in the tabernacle at the main altar of the church. It was carried away on Holy Thursday night to the altar of repose to signify Jesus' death. The candle by the tabernacle is blown out, and the tabernacle doors are left open to show that it is empty. Jesus is gone. This is quite dramatic, reminding us that Good Friday is a solemn day of mourning and prayer. The ceremony on Good Friday is not a mass, it is a communion service, Mass of the Presanctified, using the consecrated hosts from Holy Thursday. Good Friday is the only day of the year on which no masses are offered. Often the priest will begin the service by prostrating himself in front of the altar. Veneration of the cross usually takes place at this service, in which the priest and the faithful kneel before a cross and kiss it. St. Thomas Aquinas, in his Summa Theologica, offers one explanation as to why the Mass is not offered. He states that the figure, the Mass, ceases on the advent of the reality. But this sacrament is a figure and a representation of our Lord's Passion. And therefore, on the day on which our Lord's Passion is recalled as it was really accomplished, this sacrament is not consecrated. In this way, we remember the reality of Jesus' Passion, without celebrating the figure or representation. We visit the Church of St. Peter in Gallicantu, on the slopes of Mount Zion in Jerusalem. The church is built on the site of the Palace of High Priest Caiaphas, where Jesus was held prisoner on the night of his betrayal and where Peter denied knowing Jesus 3 times before the rooster crowed twice. See Mark 14 verses 66 to 72.
Tangela krat in yunuth. The Gallicantu thilothuth.
The church houses several artifacts, including an underground chamber believed to have been a prison cell where Jesus was held. and ancient steps believed to have been the staircase that led to the house of Caiaphas, the high priest, and a chapel dedicated to Saint Peter and his denial of Jesus. Inside the chapel are three icons depicting Peter's meeting with Jesus after his denial, the tears of his repentance, and the renewal of his mission by the risen Christ. We reflect on Psalm 88 in the dungeon. Psalm 88, a psalm of the sons of Korah, for the director of music, according to Mahalath Leanoth, a maskil of Heman the Ezrahite. Lord, you are the God who saves me. Day and night I cry out to you. May my prayer come before you. Turn your ear to my cry. I am overwhelmed with troubles, and my life draws near to death. I am counted among those who go down to the pit. I am like one without strength. I am set apart with the dead, like the slain who lie in the grave, whom you remember no more, who are cut off from your care. You have put me in the lowest pit, in the darkest depths. Your wrath lies heavily on me. You have overwhelmed me with all your waves. You have taken from me my closest friends, and have made me repulsive to them. I am confined and cannot escape. My eyes are dim with grief. I call to you, Lord, every day. I spread out my hands to you. Do you show your wonders to the dead? Do their spirits rise up and praise you? Is your love declared in the grave? Your faithfulness in destruction? Are your wonders known in the place of darkness? Or your righteous deeds in the land of oblivion? But I cry to you for help, Lord. In the morning my prayer comes before you. Why, Lord, do you reject me and hide your face from me? From my youth I have suffered and been close to death. I have borne your terrors and am in despair. Your wrath has swept over me. Your terrors have destroyed me. All day long they surround me like a flood. They have completely engulfed me. You have taken from me friend and neighbor. Darkness is my closest friend.